We Alaskan Natives are peoples of the land and the sea. For countless generations, Alaska has been our home. The beauty, the abundant wildlife and fish, the bounty of plants for gathering, and the clean, plentiful water. We do not take them for granted. We honor them in our prayers. We celebrate them in song and dance. But perhaps we do take for granted one basic ingredient of our lives, the air we breathe. Our villages are far from the smog and polluted cities of the lower 48. We breathe the air assuming it is clean and healthy for us, our elders, and our children. Unfortunately, this isn't always the case, as we will demonstrate in this video series.
Well, air is just as important as solid waste and water. When you're born, the first thing you breathe is air, and you will never stay away from it as long as you live. I want my kids to have clean air.
Air pollution probably contributes the most to respiratory symptoms. In people who have underlying chronic respiratory conditions, blowing silt in villages often increases the number of visits to the clinic, as well as other air pollution. Diesel fuel's been found to increase respiratory symptoms. Using a wood stove in your house has been associated with wheezing illnesses and lower respiratory infections in children.
When I'm out, when it's really dusty outside, I get sinus problems. I'm pretty sure there's a lot of people here that get sinus problems as well. Lung problems, mostly in children. Runny nose, coughing.
You know, because I work at the Eddie Hoffman Senior Center, I see a lot of the elders with asthma, they have breathing problems, shortness of breath and stuff.
Air pollution is in fact a big problem in rural Alaska. As with any serious problem, some of it you can see, some is invisible. Some is outdoors, some indoors. But we can do something about these air quality problems in every community.
I think it's like a learning process for everybody. You know, before we didn't know all these things, how harmful, you know, burning rubber just to be clean could be.
I feel proud because this is where I grew up.
If the parents and the adults know what we're up against right now and talk to the young people, they'll think about the future and try to do something about that to keep their environment clean and healthy, and especially for them, the young people.
Bye-bye. The following series of short programs will explore the causes, impacts, and prevention of five types of air pollution in our villages: road dust, solid waste burning, diesel emissions, wood stove emissions, and indoor air.